Lost his father, whose name was, what was your question? This thing started a long time ago No, but seriously, because throughout the commander, and he explains it to another kid because they did something. He said, I can't hang a tuna. I took three arrows. He killed Absalom. Absalom was dead. And so one messenger went to say that they fought Absalom and they saw some movements. They decided to the news. Then another came to him, thinking he was very good, he was friends well. And the man said to David, great news, reason for celebration. Your son Absalom is dead. But before that, David asked the question, how is young Absalom? Yes, twice or three times in scripture. Friends, no matter how bad Absalom was, and he was not nice to his father, he killed his brother. He was not nice. But even though he was not nice, even though Absalom did not have a good relationship with his father, even though he didn't treat David well, Absalom was to kill his father, and yet, when David took the news, David left and went to Sidon. And scripture tells us all Israel, all the army, heard David screaming out, crying out in total grief. Because no matter how bad his son treated him, no matter how evil, how many evils he tried to perpetrate against his father, that was his. Friends, that is unconditional love. That is, in spite of what you have done to me and against me, I still love my brother, I still love my sister, I still love my son, my daughter. In spite of everything that one of them said to me, Father, you know what? I still love my son. Like, what he didn't do to me, exactly, because he forgets. I still love my husband, and this is me. Based on the story she told me, and it's not one thing, it's plenty things. Many of us have Absaloms in our lives. And no matter what that Absalom has done to us, doing to us, based on the track record, will continue to do to us, still love that person. If you hear something happen to your son or your daughter, you know, I understand in a way when we chastise them, when somebody in their character, maybe somebody who's in drugs, maybe somebody who's in deal in bad company, crying, genius, and otherwise, when a mother says, that was a good boy, my son was a good boy. And yes, we stop at them and we say, ah, he's a good boy, I know he's in bad company, why did he do anything? And he's a pain money when he teaches me that. You know, I can't judge too much, or even if I judge, I can't condemn too much. Because in the eyes of that mother, that father, that relative, that is my child. That is my relative. And when everybody writes it off, oh, I still love that person. Friends, that is family. You gotta love your family. It's not easy. That's a serious thing. But even on a trivial, fairly light level, it happens as well. Where we have to be bigger person sometimes, how many of us can say that when you console somebody, not they don't want to kill you or anything, nothing harsh like this, but it's difficult to deal with the other person. Remember the story with Martha and Mary? Martha and Mary, Luke 10, 30. It's the story of Jesus coming into their household and Martha doing only hard work. water? Nothing. Alright, I start at the ground. You have a tradition. Well, it's what you make a part. Not now, one lesson. Relative. We are with anything. And not now, so. Sure. What? Good work, man. Nothing.
You know what was said, I can't lie, and two Doing it because
teachers from block, pass from block, again, I just await anything. Children from Africa, I am closed, but they do it fine. Not because it was requested, but it's because it's required. Remember when you have to go to pay your children? Any child is asking, mommy, I want to be now, but call the police later. Let me be it, mommy. If you leave in the house for 3 days and come back, it's so dry as a stash. You just have to pull it down and give him good with his soul. Not because it was requested, but because it was required. That's your son, by the way? Lord, sorry. Sorry, my brother. Let me put you on this one. He doesn't have a good color, you know. Whether he is, let's get a problem. Alright. But we do things not because it is requested, but because if you do it because it's requested, that's hardly love. That's a job. That might even be a career. My boss told me, and he was it by 2:30. But when somebody loves a job, or vocation as the case may be, they say, the bishop tell me to do this.
I will meet anybody who in the context of a home
some relationship that was ruptured, some relationship that is broken because of lifestyles. We can't appreciate it. We can't celebrate it. We pull up our head and say, my God, that is not how you were raised in this family. How you come up so? Mommy and them didn't grow up like this. How you acting like that? Why you change? Jesus reaches us. When we mourn the loss of our family, it's difficult, it's hard. Because in spite of everything, you can't help loving that person. That's why it hurts so much, eh? But the person didn't care about it, okay? Somebody falls on the road to break his leg. Oh my God, that's bad. Oh, oh, oh well. Anyway, I'll leave from us yesterday.
Thank you.
needs you, okay? I have to go far. Alright? And in confession, you know, confession is a powerful sacrament. If you come to confession, remember, all your sins you forgive, and that is indeed our real forgiveness. Confess them. Don't leave out any. To be a proper confession, you have to be truly contrite and sincere and desirous of those. Yes, Lord. Please, the Lord, treasure. Receive my.